try to explain this Ethereum thing in my own experience. You know, I didn't spend hundreds of hours researching it, but I had some time. I played with it, you know, and I have my own conclusion. So, you know, you can maybe learn from that. So, Ethereum allows smart contracts. And as someone who runs a business and I have a lot of contracts, definitely smart contracts in many cases would be much, much easier than all the other paperwork that we do and much more secure, you know. And so I definitely see that as a very, very good idea. You know, like, for example, renting anything, you know, I rent snowboards, I rent cars, I rent real estate. I hire people, which is kind of renting time. I rent myself, you know. So there are all these contracts, and that are all kind of, you know, you have to sit down and write them and figure them out, and you have to enforce them, and, you know, you're always at risk and stuff like that. So, you know, and having smart contracts that are self-executing and, you know, up to a point, obviously, it's not 100% automated. And, but any kind of like partial automation on execution of contracts related to, you know, like some kind of automatic payments seems like a really good idea, you know. And I'm also a poet, and, you know, I was writing poetry for a long time, for, I don't know, 20 something years. And I had a couple of shows, a couple of books. I really enjoyed. And definitely when I die, I would like my tombstone to say I was a poet before anything, because it seems like a cool thing. But nothing really happened. And then this NFT thing came up, and you know, I started selling poetry. You know, people started collecting my poetry, and that, you know, it seemed you know, interesting. You know, and suddenly there was so much movement with all my friends who are artists, and, you know, one of them, you know, most of them made money, and one of them even made like more than he made in like 10 years, and he was making already good money. And so that's just like a small micro application of smart contracts based on Ethereum in something that's like art collecting, or, and it didn't even penetrate that market too much, you know, just a little bit. And there was already like millions of dollars moving left and right, and people who never made any money were making money very easily. And, you know, through platforms that were, you know, based on Ethereum and NFTs, you know. And so that got me thinking, like, wow, so if this made such a super fast penetration, I mean, NFTs existed for a couple of years, but it really picked up in the last, let's say, 6 months, and accelerated in the last, like, March, April, May. And so if that penetrated so quickly into this art thing and generated so much money so quickly, so easily, and it was so straightforward. I mean, just imagine if that enters like all these other rent contracts and employment contracts and sales contracts and God knows what kind of other, and whatever new stuff people can come up with to formalize relationships that are, you know, have some kind of, you know, currency, wealth exchange, you know. I mean, it's going to be, you know, it's really, there is a lot of potential, you know. And then I guess when people realized how cool that was, you know, as everybody was making money with NFTs, meaning with Ethereum smart contracts, then, you know, people started, you know, minting more stuff, creating more stuff, you know, pushing it up. People got interested, price went up. And then what happened is that this, you know, gas fees increased. And gas fee means that you have to create this thing on the Ethereum, which costs, you know, you need to pay for that. So, you know, like gas fee in like April was 20 euros for me at my time when I was minting. Suddenly in like a few weeks ago, it was like 500 euros. And then obviously that kind of, then that, in my opinion, that triggered the drop, because people realized, okay, first, smart contracts are amazing. You know, they're really amazing invention of humanity, meaning getting things done in a automated and decentralized way. You know, it really makes every contract, every business relationship, legal relationship in this universe so much easier, so faster, so international. You know, like, you know, it's unbelievable. This invention is unbelievable. But then, wow, we hit the wall with this. Like, nobody's going to pay like 500 euros to do something, you know, for every action. That's really stupid. And that's when I think Ethereum started dropping, because people kind of like figured this out. And as most people don't really go and read, like spend 100 hours of reading and doing tests and calculations, you know, they figured out in practice, you know, just like me. Like I was enjoying to ride the wave of selling and participating in the smart contracts. And then suddenly I realized, well, you know, as more it grows, the more the gas fee increases because of the proof of work, I guess. That's how I understood. And then the price dropped. Now the gas fees are normal. You know, I started minting again and having fun with it. And obviously I lost like a couple of thousand euros on buying. I bought at the highest price Ethereum. I bought a couple. But I think that's something that's like they're figuring, you know, the technical people were aware of that problem, you know, the Ethereum guys. And they have to solve that because it's impossible for smart contracts to reach even 1% of potential unless the gas fees are solved, you know, and the whole, you know, the whole cost, environmental and cash cost and computational, every kind of cost related to doing something on, you know, with smart contracts or, you know, because smart contracts, Ethereum is going to be much more active than for example Bitcoin, which is just you put the money there and maybe you transfer money somewhere else, meaning wealth, not money. But Ethereum is going to be much more like, you know, moving left and right, you know, it's with, because contracts are, you know, you might have many contracts per day. And so they need to really lower that cost. You know, it's not going to be possible to keep such high costs. You know, it's going to be just an elitist thing, you know. So with proof of stake, I guess the costs should be much lower. And everybody's waiting for that because then I think then it makes much more sense to use Ethereum and smart contracts, you know. In the meantime, while I figured out how smart contracts for NFTs work, you know, NFTs being smart contracts, I guess, I was like, you know, I wish I had this like 10 years ago. I would just put it in any project that I had. It's just like amazing, you know, because I don't need to bother anymore with all the other, you know, hundreds of contracts that I have to do in paper and I don't know, like, do you agree and all that stuff. You know, that's really good. I can just code them because in my company we do kind of like process if then in emails. We organize thinking in that way. So smart contracts for me are very logical. You know, it's like you have a lot of this if then, and you can do them for small things and they're automatically enforced with money. I mean, for me that's like unbelievable. You know, that can be automated and immediately connected to payments. You know, payment automation. You know. And that's why I personally I'm very interested in this Ethereum thing. You know, it's that's the leader. You know, I think they're gonna stay there. So that's my five cents on the topic. You know, so I think it's a revolution. I think it's good. I wouldn't pay too much attention to the press left and right. I think that's ridiculous. I don't see it as something that's like a asset to play with, you know, to speculate. I think it's a new technology that really changes the how we are going to do anything, you know, because our lives are based on a lot of contracts, you know, pension contracts, you know. You know, we are all, everybody in Europe is kind of, you know, with state pensions. You know, that would be nice to have a self-executing automatically paid pension, you know. That because governments have a tendency to change you know, what they're gonna pay. You know, they'll kind of decide at some point, okay, we're changing. Well, you know, with blockchain smart contracts, you cannot do that. So once we pay the taxes and we agree on how those taxes are gonna be used and paid to us back in healthcare and pension, you know, that's done. You cannot go back and change that. So that's, I think, extremely important that, you know, there is not that centralized unilateral decision making on contracts, you know. And I just think the price dropped because people figured out this gas fee, which is like a temporary thing. Temporary in my mind is like, could be a year, could be 2 years, could be 5 years. I really don't care. I think this is kind of a technology that's not gonna, or a concept that now cannot be stopped because it's so so clear and so so good. I mean, it just provides enormous amount of value for like 90% of people, you know. And once they got it, they kind of understood it with NFTs. I understood it a little bit with NFTs. I didn't pay attention to it before, by accident being a poet, you know. And I wish I was more of a nerd like my CTO, who actually understood it like 3 years before me, and I didn't get it. and I needed poetry and NFTs to get it. And I guess people need various experiences on their own to get it, you know, because it's not so obvious, yeah. But it's gonna work out, I guess. I hope this helped.